Before this video begins, I would like to let you all know that I have a Discord server. If you want to see more updates for this channel, or just want to have a chat with me, come join it. The link is in the description below. As of the making of this video, we have discovered 4,341 exoplanets, which are planets existing outside of the solar system. Out of these systems, could any harbor life? And do we have any systems of rating an Earth-like exoplanet? One rating system which will be the focus of this video is the Earth Similarity Index, or ESI for short. This system ranks planets from 1 to 0, with 1 being completely Earth-like and 0 meaning having no Earth-like features. The four main features of the ESI system are the density of a planet, the escape velocity, radius, and surface temperature. Furthermore, these features are categorized into two categorical ESI values, interior ESI and surface ESI, with escape velocity and surface temperature making up the surface ESI, while radius and density make up the interior ESI. The interior ESI and surface ESI combined make up the overall ESI. There are many problems that come with trying to make a rating system for a planet that could support life. One issue with this system is it can only tell us how similar a planet is to Earth, but disregards the fact that life could exist in a completely different form elsewhere. Another flaw is that we do not know the actual temperatures of many exoplanets, and only that the equilibrium temperature is known. The equilibrium temperature is a measure of how much heat a planet receives if only the parent star was heating it. It disregards atmospheric composition, surface material, and any other possible source that could trap or emit heat. As a result, only estimates of surface temperatures are mostly used. A good example of this is seen in a paper authored by Madhu Kashyap, who describes that as life could potentially survive on Mars, looking for exoplanets like Mars could also help to find extraterrestrial life. Like the ESI, the Mars Similarity Index, or MSI, was proposed in his paper. Papers like this describe a planet that could be much colder, hotter, drier, or have a completely different chemical makeup to Earth and could still be habitable for life. However, while a high ESI rating does not mean that life would be present on an exoplanet, it does help to narrow down a range of planets to look at. The Planetary Habitability Laboratory from the University of Puerto Rico at Arecibo has listed 23 possible Earth-sized habitable planets. In the next section of this video, we will look at the top 10 on that list. Starting the list is Luton B, with an ESI of 0.85. Assuming Luton B has an Earth-like atmosphere, it would have an average surface temperature of just 19 degrees Celsius. However, the planet weighs almost 3 times as much as the Earth, meaning the g-forces on the planet would be much greater. In addition, a year on Luton B only lasts for 18 days, as Luton's star is a red dwarf star and is much cooler, allowing for a closer orbit. Next up is Ross 128b, with an ESI of 0.86. This exoplanet orbits a red dwarf only 11 light years away. Ross 128b is the closest known exoplanet to orbit a quiet red dwarf, as many nearby red dwarfs, including Proxima Centauri, are flare stars which could strip away at atmospheres and leave planets uninhabitable. Ross 28b would have a similar gravity, radius, and temperature to Earth, but it is thought to be situated on the inner edge of the habitable zone, and what kind of atmosphere it has would determine just how habitable it actually is. GJ1061C is next on the list, with an ESI also of 0.86. Less is known about this planet. However, if this planet had an Earth-like atmosphere, the temperature would be around 35 degrees Celsius. So if you like an entire summer planet, this is the destination for you. Another interesting fact is that a year on GJ1061 would only last for 6.7 days. And number 7, also with an ESI of 0.86, is an exoplanet from the same solar system as the previous planet, GJ1061D. With two potentially habitable exoplanets in just one solar system and only 12 light years away from Earth, this makes this solar system a promising exploration target. GJ1061D is a true story of summer and winter. Since if this planet also had an Earth-like atmosphere, it would have an average temperature of just negative 21 degrees Celsius. Proxima Centauri b comes in at 6 with an ESI of 0.87. This value is highly speculative, however, due to numerous reasons. As stated before, Proxima Centauri is a flare star with stellar winds up to 2,000 times more powerful than our Sun. When it flares, it releases enough deadly radiation to kill even the most UV-resistant microbes on Earth. This fact, combined with the fact that it may have no atmosphere, makes the planet less likely to be habitable. With an ESI of 0.9, Kepler-1649c is a more promising candidate. It has 1.06 times the mass of the Earth, making gravity on this planet very similar to our own. It also receives up to 75% the light from the star that the Earth does from the Sun. However, despite these facts, little else is known about the planet, and it is 300 light years from Earth. At 4 is TRAPPIST-1d, with an ESI of 0.9. This exoplanet is part of a fascinating system of 7 planets. As the planet is tidally locked, meaning one side always faces the Sun, it is a candidate for being an eyeball planet, which could have the Sun-facing side looking very different to the night-facing side. However, the red dwarf that TRAPPIST-1d orbits is also a very active star and may make life on this planet unlikely. K272e, with an ESI of 0.9, is located 217.1 light years away. It is around 30% larger than Earth, but double the mass. It is also tidally locked, just like TRAPPIST-1d. Despite the larger mass and tidal locking, it orbits within the habitable zone of its star, and unlike our solar system, it could have similar conditions on its surface for the next 100 to 200 trillion years. TOI-700d is at 2. With an ESI of 0.93. It is within the habitable zone of its star, the stellar winds are expected to be like Earth, and the temperature on the surface, assuming the planet has an Earth-like atmosphere, would be around negative 4 degrees Celsius. With everything seeming so right about this planet, one of the few downsides is that it is over just 100 light years away from the Earth. At number 1 is Tea Garden Star B, with an ESI of 0.95. The mass of this planet may be just 1.05 times the mass of the Earth, leading to very similar gravity conditions. Its star is relatively inactive, and it is within the habitable zone of its star. Unlike TOI-700d, this planet is only 12 light years away. If liquid water is discovered here, it could become one of the first exoplanets we send probes to. With our Milky Way galaxy possibly containing over 400 billion exoplanets, we have only scratched the surface of the number of possibly habitable exoplanets we could one day settle. An Earth clone is almost certain to exist in the Milky Way, and it's only a matter of time before we find it. Until next time, thanks for watching.